Hi everybody, my name is Karen Martin. I'm the Marketing Director at GoldBio Technology, and in this video I'm going to show you how to calculate transformation efficiency.
Transformation efficiency is just a way of measuring how well or how efficiently your cells can take up DNA, and it's expressed as the number of transformants per microgram of your plasmid DNA. So the general formula is going to look like this. You have TE, or transformation efficiency, equals the number of colonies that you count over the mass of plated plasmid DNA. And then you take that over the dilution that you end up using. So let's look at an example. In this example, let's say that you have 1 microliter of 10 picogram per microliter DNA. And for conversion's sake, that's 0.00001 microgram per microliter DNA. And then let's say you add that to a 25 microliter E. coli cell suspension. From there, you add the suspension into 975 microliters of SOC recovery medium. And then you do your first dilution. So for that first dilution, you take 10 microliters of cell with SOC medium and you dilute that into 990 microliters of SOC medium, and then from there you're ready to plate. So we'll say you plated 50 microliters and after incubation you counted 95 colonies. So we know our colony count, that's 95 colonies, but what we don't know is the mass of plated plasmid DNA. And to get that, we're going to have to do a few easy steps. The first thing I like to do, though, is break things down into two components. I like to break things down into my knowns and my unknowns. So my knowns are the following. I have 1 microliter of plasmid DNA. And then I had 10 picograms per microliter of DNA, and that converts to 0.00001 microgram per microliter of DNA. That's my concentration there. The first dilution that I did was where I took the 10 microliters and put it into the 990 microliters of SOC medium. So we're going to look at that in terms of the amount we pulled out and our total volume. So that is 10 microliters over 1,000 microliters. Then our total volume that we've been using is 1,000 microliters. And our plated volume is 50 microliters. And at the end, after incubation, we counted 95 colonies. Okay, so after solving my knowns, the next thing I want to look at are the things I need to solve for, or my unknowns. So the first thing I want to know is the total mass of plasmid DNA. Then I want to know the fraction of DNA that was used from sample. Basically, that's my second dilution. And then I'm going to look for the mass of plated plasmid DNA, which is this part right here. So let's start with the first part here. We'll look at our total mass of plasmid DNA. And in this example, it's really easy to solve, but we're going to math it out anyway so you see how it works. So we take our volume, our plasmid volume, times our concentration, and that's 1 microliter times 0.00001 microgram per microliter. The microliters cancel out. And, we're going to be left with this, basically. So 0.00001 microgram. The next thing I'm going to do is look at the fraction of DNA used from sample. And what I'm doing is I'm looking at the amount plated over my total volume. It's as easy as that. So 50 microliters over 1,000 microliters. And that's 0.05. And then the last part is the mass of plated plasmid DNA, that is. So I'm going to take the total DNA mass, this part, and I'm going to multiply that by my second dilution, this part, and I'll have my number. So 0.001 microgram times 0.05, and that gives me 0.5 micrograms. So this is the amount that was actually plated. So now I'm ready to use my formula here. So I've got my 95 colonies. And I'll take that over the mass of DNA that I actually used, or the plated mass of plasmid DNA. And then I also need to take that over my first dilution here. So that's 0.01. So my answer is 1.9 times 10 to the 10th, and that's colony forming units per microgram of DNA. So that's it. Ultimately, when you're learning this, you're gonna take what you know and use it to solve for what you don't know, and then you just plug in the numbers. But if you don't feel like doing all that math, GoldBio does have a transformation efficiency calculator on our website. All you have to do is check it out at goldbio.com.
If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up, subscribe, even add it to a playlist. We hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.